Hello, my name is Mbadi Ngwabe. I was born and bred here in Joburg. So I grew up in Kagiso, a small little township in the West Rand, raised by both my mom and dad. And growing up, I was quite the feisty kid, if I must say. I was very like goal orientated. I had a vision, and every time I wanted to do something, I'd actually do it. Like little challenges that I'd have, I'd challenge myself, and I'd do those mini challenges. High school for me was very great. I challenged myself to go to a high school where I knew no one. So to meet new friends, started off tough, the transition from primary to high school in a totally different environment. But I met very great people, great friendships. But what stands out for me was the transition, which was very tough. But the friendships that I made there as well, they were also great ones. I went to university, so I'm a BCom Economics and Econometrics graduate. Now that was tougher. So I walk in there and I think I know it all. Because I passed in high school, it was great, the marks were amazing. I thought it would be as easy, but it was tough because a three-year degree took me 5 years to complete. And that was my biggest challenge because you're used to flowing when doing things, but now it's all of a sudden challenges, which was very, very tough. After varsity, I moved to applying for graduate programs, and that procedure was not too bad. Unlike people that stay at home for 6 months, no, after varsity I got a job immediately, and I thought, yes, this is it, I'm in corporate and it's supposed to flow smoothly. And you get there and it's not it. It's not exciting. It's not what you thought it would be, to a point where I lost my job. And that was even tough. I mean, no one wants to lose their job. You want to be the one that hands in that resignation letter, not the other way around. So it was a tough pill to swallow, I won't lie about that. Losing my job made me value doing what you are passionate about. Stop following what the world or what everyone perceives that you should be. I mean, you go to varsity and your parents say, go study, go do this. But you walk in there and you are miserable. I hated it every single day of my life to a point that they let me go. And that's when I said the next move is to do what Mbali wants to do, what Mbali has always envisioned to do as a little girl. And I've always wanted to own a hair salon. More than anything, I wanted a hair salon. Why I decided to open a kid's hair salon? My personal experiences growing up. I remember dreading doing my hair, the crying. I remember they would pull you, and the famous Zulu saying was, "Ubuhle buyabekezelwa sisi," and they would just leave you there and you'd have to do your hair because ubuhle buyabekezelwa. And I remember I grew up having a passion, loving kids, and when I'd walk into a hair salon, and I'd see a little girl crying and I'd be like, that was me. It resonated within me. And what my love and passion for kids is that I love that they're small, they're innocent, they're precious. And I love preserving that innocence. And nothing frustrates me when I see a little girl with a Brazilian hair or that soft dread. And I just want us to keep kids to being kids. Let's keep that innocence. Let's preserve it as much as we can. There is a time that's coming for Brazilian hair. Hence, I decided to open this. My love for kids, I hate seeing them crying, I hate seeing them miserable, and let's create that platform for them where they don't have to be afraid of salons. Salons are not big, bad, horrible places, because that's what we grew up seeing. The process of starting the hair salon inside corporate while you're still in a job was doing your research. So, unlike other entrepreneurs, I didn't just take the plunge. I wanted to take a calculated risk. So I go into an incubation program because you hear the stats that most small businesses fail within the first 6 months. And I told myself that I can't be that small business. So I go into an incubation program. They make you do research. And then I start researching on the people that I see in corporate, the mums that you meet there. And I ask them, how's your experience when you take your child to a salon? And that's when they start giving you feedback. Terrible, terrible, my kid cries, my kid screams, all of that information. And that's when I saw that my business idea is actually viable, because there is a problem and I'm coming in here with the solutions. Some moms would even ask me, where is the salon so I can take my child this weekend? So it's like, it's still at the back of my head, but it's gonna happen. So when you're prepared for something, I know there's a saying, luck prepares, I don't know what that saying, but when I had already been prepared, so when I did lose my job, I think that was the push in that right direction to say, you're already in corporate, you're already planning all of this, you just needed to be booted out for you to actually walk into this. The next was, in that incubation program, you're given a coach. That coach is the person that's pushing you on the background, that's telling you, have you looked for a place? Have you signed a lease? Have you bought your equipment? Have you found, you know, all of that. You have someone that's cheering you on the background to keep you going. And that was that. That was how it all came together. So with regards to funding, you lose your job, but you use that Provident Fund. I had been saving on the side, using friends and family. My mom, thank God for her, for having a mom that believes in your dreams. I mean, not a lot of black parents are like that, especially if you're gonna lose a job. So she was one of the funders of the brand. So it was savings, it was Provident Fund, and my mom, some of that money she retired with, guys. The earliest challenges when opening the Kitty's Corner brand was getting the clientele, getting feet to walk into your salon. I mean, I believe with the hair space, it's a very personal, people have personal relationship with their stylists, hairdressers. So moving, letting Cindy leave her trusted stylist to come to Kitty's Corner, this new brand that no one knows, you know, that claims to do Kitty's hair. So those were the earlier challenges, financing the business. So I opened the business, but I didn't have working capital, which most entrepreneurs don't think about, because you still need the feet to come in, but they weren't enough. So it was tough. Retaining hairdressers, it is hard. It is hard. Firstly, you don't find as many hairdressers that can do the work that you want, yeah, to execute the way you want to. And I think it all boils down with finding the right people for your brand. I chopped and changed hairdressers month after month. But then when you find the perfect fit, people that will understand your brand, where you're going with the brand, and they want to move and grow the brand with you, I think that is the best formula. If I could get that from the start, if it started from the, yeah, from the beginning. So when you find the people that understand how to do the hair, how it's the lines you take when you do kitty hair, because kids get very restless. So I can't be doing Simpson lines when I do kitty hair. Yeah. So we understand that not every child wants to be touched on their hair. So we always have an assistant that's always willing to help with the child that cries, so that we make the experience a bit more pleasant for them. So you're not going to be watching adult soapies, for instance, at Kitty's Corner. Our cars, to keep them busy whilst they're doing their hair, we give them a little tablet just to keep them busy while they're doing their hair, and there is a little play area where they can build their Legos, play with cars, just those little things to keep kids busy whilst they're doing their hair. So as we've grown in business, we've realized that there are different types of afros with different textures, and therefore we decided to go for local products, because they understand the textures of the hair, they understand our climate, and we really want to preserve the afro for as long as you can before going to chemically process the hair. So usually I always say, when mommy is ready for her to do her hair. So mommy can be ready when she's 3 or when she's 9 months old, because our youngest was 9 months old. So it's you talk your little one through the process. If they're ready to do their hair at the salon, and that's when we are also ready. our vision is to grow this brand. I don't want to only see Kitty's Corner here in North Riding. The KZN child, the Limpopo child needs to have an experience at a children's hair salon as well. We want to grow our brand, have our own product range. See it sitting at these local, retailers in South Africa. So more than anything, just to expand and franchise eventually. What keeps me growing Ngule brand is my passion for it. I've been passionate about this from a tender age, and I am still passionate. I wake up in the morning and I look forward to going to Kitty's Corner. I look forward on improving the brand. Where there are shortfalls, kutisilungise. We are not a perfect brand, but kancane kancane, we're trying to get to perfection. So that's my passion drives me even more to get it to being perfect.